Thank you so much. So just a little bit about my background. I was born in Sri Lanka, and in fact, I was never meant to be born. My mother contracted rubella in Africa and was asked to abort the pregnancy by five different physicians because her life was in threat and so was mine. And my mother decided to actually just believe for a miracle and that I would be born, and I was. I then entered my career in the oil industry, as Richard said, and in fact I probably shouldn't have been there either. A few months before I was recruited, the oil company looked at their 15 board members and saw that they were all male, white, over 40, and they implemented a reverse discrimination policy and they came looking for someone like me. So the roadmap of our life, where we start and where we end up, is actually based on a series of decisions. Some that we make and some that our ancestors have made. And so I want to talk to you about how understanding how we make decisions could potentially unlock the financing and the delivery of the SDGs at scale. It was actually Nobel Peace Prize winner, Professor Daniel Kahneman, who started a revolution into the understanding of the human mind. And he actually discovered that there's two systems of thinking. There is the logical part of our mind, which is capable of analyzing really complex problems and coming up with rational and deliberate answers. However, it's very slow, it takes up a lot of energy, and it's very, very lazy, so we hardly actually use it. A lot of us think that we make very rational decisions, but actually there's another system of thinking that takes over. This system of thinking is so powerful that it's taking over the thousands of decisions that we're making every day and the things that we say and do. This way of thinking, it's fast, it's automatic. However, it's based on a series of cognitive biases. Cognitive biases that are so strong that it actually weights it in favor of loss instead of gain, negative experiences instead of positive ones, and the now instead of the future. The problem comes when we allow these cognitive biases to make decisions that we need our slow, logical mind to be doing, yet we give it over to our intuitive mind. And Kahneman discovered, and this is what he won the Nobel Peace Prize for, was that the area of our lives where cognitive biases is creating the biggest issue in humanity today is with anything to do with money. So when I founded Worldwide Generation 2 years ago with the aim to be an independent facilitator, bring government, business, civil society, and communities around partnership to the goals, I quickly realized, well, how are we going to actually deliver this? What is going to actually deliver a global resolution on poverty, inequality, and climate change by 2030? How are we going to get investors to invest the trillions of dollars that we're going to need to deliver the goals? How are we going to get delivery partners to deliver at scale in a sustainable and ethical way and responsible way? How are we going to ensure that the communities that we're developing these solutions for are actually going to adopt them? And ultimately, how are we going to know that the solutions that we're all coming in and trying to put our hard-earned time and money into is actually working towards the 2030 target? And that's when I turned to technology. I'm actually not a tech entrepreneur. I knew how to write the system and actually got a group of incredible developers to come alongside this and actually deliver this. It's called G17 Eco. It's a digital marketplace and a monitoring ecosystem. What it does is that anyone, any project, any initiative, any company, anybody can come onto the platform and we'll map you to the SDGs, and then we have basically these robots that go and get the data from all of the different stakeholders that we need to see what the impact is having on the ground. So you could actually be doing a project here and know how it's affecting someone's life in another country. And giving the voice to a lot of these voiceless communities that can tell us actually what this this impact is having on their lives in real time. I believe that this transparency and the assurance that this will give all of the different stakeholders will help to alter these biases that we have. They'll actually see that they can invest in, you know, some of the African countries, and, you know, people are not going to run away with their money. They can actually give money to their favorite NGO and know that they're actually going to deliver that the goals that they wanted it to. And it's going to actually affect the people that they wanted to affect. So that decision that my mother made to, you know, really have me and go forward, the decision that that oil company made to find someone, a female leader for their board, those decisions were considered long, hard decisions. But really, we haven't got very much time to make those long, hard decisions. We're going to have to change people's cognitive biases, those biases, very quickly. And the only way we can do that is we can actually show them that it is going to, that these things do work. And so, you know, we are limited. You know, we are not perfect. We are irrational in all kinds of ways. My hope is that G17 can help us build a world that is compatible with this, but helps all of us make better decisions. We've developed G17 Eco as a supportive backbone and a digital tool to anyone that wants to deliver these goals and be part of a sustainable future. And so we welcome you to please go to our website called worldwidegeneration.co and have a look and see how we can partner with you, how you can partner with us. And there's a lot of ladies in the room. I really believe it's the feminine energy, not the female, the feminine energy that's going to disarm a lot of the destruction and chaos in our world today. And I really want the women to rise up and stand together. Let us not be our worst enemies, actually. Sometimes women can be slightly threatened by each other, and I think we need to unite. And we need to take this forward and deliver the goals. Thank you.